Shibna Ryan Chandapal, a local hero here at Border. And Guyanese flag, well, it's blowing in the wind, pretty windy here, but he's going to be facing a hat-trick delivery from Brad Hogg. He got a standing ovation once he came onto the playing surface, Chandapal. But at the moment, it's all Brad Hogg. Two deliveries in two balls.
Well, Brad Hogg's walking around like a caged lion at the moment. He's really hyper at the best of times, let alone being on a hat-trick. He's doing circles out there. Can't wait to bowl this delivery. Steve Waugh's just having a little chat there. I think he wants to get in another fielder around the bat. Well, we saw a few hat-tricks in the World Cup. We're going to see another one in Test cricket now. Chandapal, very good batsman, just what they need at the moment to steady the ship.
And what he will be thinking, Chandapal, is that he's got a lot of fieldsmen, well, encircled around the bat, rightly so. Steve Waugh stepping up the pressure. And he will be very, very careful. He's a stodgy character, very oblivious to what's going on around him, apart from the ball being delivered. And he's off the mark. That's the type of character he does show, Chandapal. Faster one from Brad Hogg, but ill-directed.
Yes, it wasn't what he meant. It was supposed to be the quicker one in at leg stump. He's got it wide. It was hit in the air, but with all those batsmen close by, it was struck firmly. Gets him away. So the hat-trick eludes Hogg. The fielders go back out now. Just leaves Lehman in there at bat pad on the onside. And Matthew Hayden in slip.
Off the pad. And let's have a look at the dismissals. This is the last one. Marlon Samuels going after a wrong on that was relatively wide. Now, Matthew Hayden is one of the best catchers in the game. There's no doubt about that. Just look at how wide it is. Just think that he was a little intimidated, went for it, trying to get off the mark, put some pressure back on the bowler. But the bowler won the battle this time round.
Yeah, so he wasn't to the pitch of the ball. That was the main thing, and he still went at it hard. That's where he's got to learn a lesson on that one. You're not to the pitch of the ball, you renege on the shot and just kill the pace of the bat so that doesn't happen. By flashing at it like that, he just made the ball carry that much further to Hayden, made it simple. Good piece of bowling, but well, I just think a poor shot there from Samuels.
And Chandapal got off the mark. He's facing his first delivery, hat-trick delivery, but it's Andy Bickle. Top shot from Chandapal. Just stood up and caressed it down the ground. Such an easy-paced pitch.
Well, that was. He just struck that back disdainfully past Bickle and past the man at mid-off, which is Darren Lehman. Just look at this. He walks across, Swiss waltzes into it, and just, well, pats it back past the bowler.
Yeah, you couldn't say it was a bad delivery. Just look at the length of it. But this is what can happen if you get in on this service and really apply yourself. Chandapal has played here often enough. He knows the vagaries of this pitch. He knows what it takes, knows what is required.
Well, it's not a scary wicket, is it? There's been a few soft dismissals this morning, Bish. I mean, that's been the trouble. I mean, the Australians have bowled okay. They bowled steady, but West Indies have done them some favours out there this morning.
Was hit rather firmly, so he as well, Chandapal, is in an up-tempo mood. Let's have a look though at the first of two wickets to fall in that Hogg over. The first was Wavell Hines. Not really, I think you called it right, didn't really get his upper half over the ball, leaning into the drive.
Didn't quite get to the pitch of the ball, but had he been going forward a bit more, got his head over the ball, it would have kept this down. The bat's out in front of his head, and that's why he scooped that up. He got a similar shot the previous over the Hogg, and he hit it nicely along the ground. This one was just a touch shorter and scooped it straight to Langer. So what I'm saying, after winning the toss and on this wicket, that's, well, Lara would be really disappointed. He's at batting at the moment, and, well, he's doing it so easily. Mind you, he is a much better player than all the rest anyway, but this pitch is pretty easy. It's a poor result at the moment.
Struck in front. Now that could be close. He's given him. It's taken a long time, but Ashoka De Silva raises the dreaded finger. The West Indies captain heads for the pavilion. The faces are long. The local fans are sad because The West Indies are in deep, deep trouble. Andy Bickle strikes.
Well, that is a huge wicket there for Bickle. I was just a little concerned whether Lara had gone across too far. He does, on the move, move across his stumps. Bickle's bowled a fuller one for once. Lara, well, it was just a matter of whether he was caught in front. Ahsoka De Silva thinks he was. We'll just have a look at the replay. Now, there he is, shuffling across. Well, it just hit him on the round off stump, is it? Little bit of doubt there, but it playing across the delivery like that. Ahsoka De Silva took his time. Up goes the finger. And that's a bad result for the West Indies. 53 for 5.
Ridley Jacobs, the new West Indies batsman, facing Andy Bickle. Leaves it alone. Last ball of the over. Successful over for Bickle. 53 for 5 is the West Indies score at the moment. And Ridley Jacobs has a lot of work to do. A man who will feel to himself he needs to produce a good score. This is how Lara went. Definitely pitched on. But you just feel, Tom, or I feel, that might have gone past the off stump. It had to come back a lot more than it did.
Well, I think that was a fortunate dismissal for Andy Bickle there. It's pitched in line, but the only stump it's going to hit is off stump. So that, therefore, gives me a bit of doubt. It's not going over the top. But I think it might have been just a bit wide. And like you say, it needed to straighten up a lot more. It was close, but, well, I think Bickle's lucky there. It's his first wicket, and it's a huge wicket there and a big blow for the West Indies. But Brian Lara might be the second one out of those five that's been unlucky this morning.
Well, he does celebrate like a man who's always playing his last game. Just look at Lara's... the leg stump behind his legs there, and you can tend to feel, I certainly feel, that it would have gone past the off stump, but the finger goes up from Ahsoka De Silva.
That's magnificently struck. He really has given that something, Chanderpaul. It stood up. It's a slow pitch, as you could imagine, for a bowler of Brettney's pace to be hammered like that.
There are a few bowlers in the world that if you're a puller or a hooker, you'd say, I won't pull or hook these men. Brettley, under normal circumstances, would be that. So that tells two things. One, the slowness of the pitch, but also that Chanderpaul is in a very good aggressive mood. The shot of the morning so far, beautifully into position early. And when you hit Brettley in front of square leg, you are playing pretty well.
Hit that pretty well too, but found the fielder this time. This is Chanderpaul, not as we often see him. Got 100 here last year in the test match against India on this ground, and exciting his home fans. He's got it past now. He really hit that beautifully, just delayed the shot a little bit longer than the previous one. Middle of the bat and flying across this rock-hard outfield for another boundary to Chanderpaul.
Just a bit of practice the ball before, and now he finally got his radar right. And just waited a fraction longer, was able to hit it backward a point instead of 2 point. And that's a very good shot. We saw Lara play a beautiful late cut between gully and second slip during his innings. That's the 10th boundary of this innings. Gained some field manoeuvres. Extra man in the offside to encourage Bickle to bowl on that off stump, but bowl it full. Got some protection on the drive.
Lovely shot down the ground. Fast outfield, 4 runs at border. Always is going to be 4 runs on that boundary at border. Once you push it past the border, it's a short boundary. And Chanderpaul picks up the 11th boundary of the innings.
Full face of the bat. And Bickle tried in vain to get a foot to it, but he missed it by a long way. Lovely flush meaning of the bat and the ball. And always 4. Get it past the logo, and it's down the hill for 4.
Fifth bowler on now, Stuart McGill will come on. You have maybe a couple of overs before lunch. Unusual this, with a score at 80 for 5, to have five bowlers used before the first break in the first day of a test match. Of course, has played against the West Indies, was in the Caribbean last time in 99. He's got it through and that'll go for four. Another boundary to Chanderpaul, flicking away down through mid-wicket. That's his fifth boundary for Chanderpaul. Carrying him on to 28 now. He's got a full toss through. That really was an offering. And Jacobs picked his spot. Got another boundary. A lot of boundaries for the West Indies in this innings, but too many wickets.
I don't think that'll please Ricky Ponting too much in there at silly mid-off. The full toss going just to the left of Ponting, just shying away from the full swing of the bat. And the most important part about that shot was the placement. There's a man at cover and a man at mid-off.
First one was the leg before dismissal of Devon Smith. In his first test match, getting a very unfortunate decision, a thick inside edge, which eluded the attention of Rudy Kurtz and the umpire, and brought him leg before. And then Darren Ganga on the back foot, bowled all over the place by Gillespie without scoring, and West Indies under pressure early on. Lara's response was typical. Some flashing strokes, five boundaries in all. We'll see here, he had six in total, and that was certainly was the most delicate of the lot. But then he fell after the dismissal of Hines, a loose shot, driving down to mid-off. Hawks' first wicket in the very next ball, a loose drive from Marlon Samuels to the googly, edged to slip. And then leg before wicket, long deliberation by Asoka Da Silva before he gave Lara leg before and sent him on his way. Since then, Chanderpaul has taken over the mantle of the attacker, which was Lara's forte early on, and he has gone on to 28. Jacobs has come in to join him, and the West Indies have moved to 89 for 5. A couple of streaky shots by the two batsmen, but some very robust ones as well.
That's a bad delivery. Got the treatment from Chanderpaul.
Well, this pitch is slow, isn't it? When you get it wrong, the ball just looks so bad because of the lack of pace of the pitch. He's just dropped it in a touch short, but just the slowness of the pitch. See, that's not real short, but it just come off so slowly. Chanderpaul had all the time. He could have whacked that wherever he liked.
That's got through. That should bring up the 100 for the West Indies. Might not quite get to the boundary as Jason Gillespie chases. Coming back for the third. 101 for 5 to the West Indies. Three figures up.
Now, that wasn't all that short. That wasn't a bad delivery from Hogg, but Chanderpaul was just quickly onto this. He's in pretty good form, Chanderpaul. Runs since the World Cup. And there's the 100. Well, this one might get through. McGill's giving good chase. Sorry, it's Justin Langer, the fielder out there. He really had to hurry. It's probably the longest part of the ground that that ball was struck to.
Well, we saw the 100 coming up for the West Indies. Now it's a 50 partnership between these two left-handers, Ridley Jacobs and Shivnarine Chanderpaul. got together with a score on 53 for 5. And the West Indies in desperate trouble. They are still in trouble, but at least they are trying to fight back. That should be 4. It is.
Well, that was a bad delivery from Hogg. Chanderpaul quickly under that one. Smashed it through point. 108 for 5.
Few runs, we'll have to wait to see what the umpire signals here. A lot of turn again for Stuart McGill. Byes is the signal. Nothing touched.
Well, that mid-wicket area is the area that Ridley Jacobs fancies, but like I said before, and you said, Michael, yourself, he's got to get to the pitch of the ball, otherwise it's very dangerous against a man like McGill that bowls, well, big spin. Well, there's that one. It's off the thigh pad, the leg bias.
Well, he's not playing a stroke. That is why they're appealing like that. He's getting a lot of turns, Stuart McGill. The ball certainly is heading back towards the stumps. Problem is, can the umpire definitely say it would have hit?
Now, that's the trouble with McGill, isn't it, is the amount of spin. Wow. It's come back a long way, but it hit his leg. There's the ball there, but it hit his leg wide of the crease. It hit more near the knee and ran along his leg. That's what made that look, well, probably better than it was.
Very dangerous shot, that. Cutting against the spin.
Well, he's keeping him interested, isn't he, this over? Now, see where it hit just under his knee there and then ran along his leg way outside off. That's not going to hit the stumps, but that's the difficulty for the umpire.
That's a good shot. Jason Gillespie again at the backward square. Imagine that. No run for the shot. Ridley Jacobs seems to have done himself a bit of damage. Unable to get up and run. The Westerners don't need this.
Well, he seems to be holding his thigh. There's the shot. Over he goes. This is one if he landed on his bat. Let's have another look. Oh, no, he's on the way down. He's complained about something. Yeah, thigh. It's on that left thigh there. So this is not what you need at 512. And the wicketkeeper. There he goes. It's that outside leg. And he just didn't move at all. Struck it well. Got no run for his trouble, just to add insult to injury. Well, you can see the grimace on his face as soon as he tried to play that shot. He was on the way down.
And here comes Wavell Hines. He'll be running for Ridley Jacobs. I've seen a bit of confusion created by runners in the past. Let's see what happens here.
Well, it's not going to do much for his footwork. It didn't really exist against the spinners beforehand, and now with a, well, an injured leg, it's going to make it even less, which will make it a little difficult to play against these spin. Except for a ball like that, of course.
Not through. Just got through, and Ridley Jacobs has collapsed again.
Well, he's even struggling to get off the ground now. I mean, up off the ground, not off the ground itself. Played that shot well, just timed it nicely, placed it nicely. There's that back foot. He just can't put any weight on it whatsoever. The minute he tried to get on the back foot to play that cut shot, he just fell over.
117 for 5. Looking a lot better than 53 for 5, but still in a bit of bother here at the West Indies. And of course, Ridley Jacobs' injury now making things just a bit worse. That's gone. Has it gone all the way? It has. That's the 50 for Shivnarine Chandrapal as well.
Well, a very fine 50 indeed. 50 off just 37 deliveries. And brought this one up with a 6, just in front of square. Casual as you like, he dobs Stuart McGill through that, square mid-wicket region. Over the ropes he goes.
That will be Baez, I would think. Umpire will have a look at this and let us know. It'll go all the way. Yes, it does. Baez is the signal from umpire Ashoka da Silva. The West Indies will take them whichever way they come.
Yes, difficult one there for Gilchrist to haul in. No chance on this. Striking the legs of Chanderpaul. McGill trying to whip this one through. Actually, I don't think it hit the legs. It's just straight out Baez.
Through the gap again. Won't get to the boundary. Jason Gillespie chasing. Well, he's looking for three. Not attempting to get the third one on this occasion, Shivnarayan Chanderpaul.
A wild return there too from Gillespie. And the backup fielder scurrying everywhere. Good shot that, isn't he? Just all the time in the world, just rolled his wrist, picked it through mid-wicket. Gillespie had to give a long chase. And Bickle was the man, the culprit that threw the ball. It took three of them to stop it. It's a little bit of an awkward bounce out there. That's what I say about that cover region. Difficult to feel there.
Well played. Very well played. Much better time. That will go all the way.
Well, that was beautifully timed. Just dropped the bat on it, placed it beautifully. Ball racing away in the mid-wicket region. Well, they were fairly severe on McGill's previous over. And now already six from two deliveries of Hogg.
That has resulted in a change in the field. The forward short leg disappears to a short mid-wicket. So Chanderpaul's aggressive play forcing Steve Waugh to go a bit more on the defensive. This was that shot again. So easy, just timing and placement. Full toss, that should go.
Well, another good shot there. Poor delivery. He struck it beautifully. His timing this morning has been just so superb, Chanderpaul. That's been the highlight of his batting. That's money for Jab, but nowhere in the world is he ever going to catch this. He just struck it beautifully. It's gone like a rocket past him.
Well, it's gone a long way and over the fence for six. So just keeping it up. No man out on that fence. There is a man at backward square leg. Man at square leg and short mid-wicket. So now the man from square leg, Ponting, goes out to mid-wicket.
Good shot. No-nonsense type of innings from Shivnarayan Chanderpaul. It was just up there in the slot, and he's not missed out on anything loose today at all. His timing has been superb, and he's hit with a lot of power.
That's four. Well, he's been aggressive since the moment that he walked to the crease with the West Indies in trouble. And he's found the middle of the bat on more occasions than he hasn't. And he's putting some pressure back on the Australian bowlers and fieldsmen. Steve Waugh having to make probably more fielding changes due to Chanderpaul than he has for a long time.
It's not been risky batting at all. Got a big stride in. Anything that's been marginally off the line has been punished.
Top edge for four again. Down the leg side. We said earlier that McGill bowls a lot of balls that can be hit for four. Steve Waugh's quite happy to cope with that because he does bowl wicket-taking balls, but he hasn't done today. 15 runs off this over already with one ball remaining.
It's not been the tidiest spell from McGill and Hogg since lunch. Chanderpaul knows this ground very well, and he will force a change in bowling, you feel, after a while. Not too long from now.
That boundary brought up the 100 partnership of just 96 balls between these two. From 5 for 153, they're taking the score from 5 for 53. That may go to the boundary. It's very dusty down that part of the ground and a lot of wear and tear where the players walk out. And not too much grass coverage. So once it gets about two-thirds of the way to the fence, it races away.
Almost went to hand, not too far away from a Steve Waugh, as we will see on this shot. Almost. So, well, maybe a moral victory, but frustration as well, because it's another boundary.
That's in the air and dropped. Extra cover and chance for run out, and he's out. No. Got confused with all the runners and the batsmen and the helmets and the bats. So the drop catch by Brett Lee, he got both hands to it. He should have caught it in the end. It wasn't hit hard. And that's is what you said, Ian. Get him on the front foot trying to push through the ball. He doesn't want to go forward.
Yeah, he can't afford to get as big a stride in Jacobs as he would like because of the injured leg. And that catch, well, it's something you'd expect to be taken. And Bickle didn't see Wavell Hines to the left of his screen. And then he realized finally that there was indeed a runner. Fooled a lot of people around the ground as well, I can tell you. That's what happens when you've got a runner. Just complicates matters just a bit. But certainly a missed chance from Brett Lee.
Certainly fooled at least one of the commentators. Oh, lovely shot. That may well be the shot of the day. Just rocking back. He played a similar shot to Brett Lee, but I think he may well have even timed that one just a fraction better. Shanvall now brings up his 500th run against Australia.
It's been a fantastic rate of scoring. As good as this shot was, the run rate now has climbed to just below 5 runs and over. 73 runs have been added in 9.5 overs since lunch. Just in position so quickly, and not just working it around, not helping it around, smashing it to the backward square. Might be asking, why wasn't he batting a little higher up, Chanderpaul? Maybe 5 instead of 6. But he's doing an excellent job at the moment. 500 runs against Australia. Wonderful average of over 50.
The end of another exciting over. Drop catch and a lovely shot for 4. 2 boundaries off the over. 33 overs only gone. It is 5 for 162.
Updating Fox Sports News. After 3 days of heavy rain at Augusta National, the first round of the US Masters was called off with the course completely waterlogged. It's the first time in 20 years an entire day's play has been washed out. In a startling move, Perth has sacked coach Alan Black just a week after playing in the NBL Grand Final Series. Black coached the Wildcats over 2 stints, never failed to make the playoffs and led them to a championship. And Andrew Ryan will replace injured lock Travis Norton for the Bulldogs' clash against the Knights in Newcastle tonight.
Get the complete picture with Fox Sports News tonight at 7. This classic Ashes moment on Fox Sports is brought to you by Hahn.
That's a delightful stretch.
Done it again. It's there to be hit. There it goes again.
There it is. And he punches the air with delight, and why not? That's been a brilliant 100. Brilliant.
Enjoy a Hahn Premium Light during the cricket.
Chandler on 79, Jacobs on one leg, and 26. It is McGill continuing from the Regent Street end. And that's what he doesn't want to do. There's a chance for round at the bowler's end. Steve Waugh throws, and McGill's in the right spot, but missed. One of the problems with the runner. The runner's a long way away from where Shanderpool's at the non-strikers end. He's probably some 40 metres from him. It's a noisy cricket ground.
Catch.
And dropped again. So McGill getting one hand to it. Hard to tell from this end.
Well, a fantastic amount of action happening over the last half an hour. And once again, the length trying to draw Jacobs onto the front foot. You're right about that runner. This is that drop catch. Once again, off balance and just spooning it in the air reasonably powerfully. He had to be a good effort from Stuart McGill, going against his momentum, taking him off to the left and coming back to his right. And I think Chanderpaul dictating the pace. Steve Waugh forced to set a more defensive offside field to Chanderpaul. Runs, overthrows. It's all gone wrong for Australia. 5 runs in the end. Brett Lee, after dropping a catch, has erred again, and his captain will not be very pleased.
Not sure what Brett Lee thought then. I think that he may have seen the runner at square leg and just thought it was a fieldsman. He just looked up. That's a view that Lee has. He sees the fieldsman, and then, of course, it goes to the boundary. So I think there can be some moderate excuse for Lee on that occasion. It won't appease Jason Gillespie. Outstanding session so far for the West Indies. Made the point at lunch. These two really have to be there at tea time. And gee, if they kept this rate up, it would be outstanding for them. Shanderpaul on 84 not out. That is his highest score against Australia. That beats his 82 in Brisbane way back in 1996. And flicked away. That should go to the boundary as well, because Gillespie is very, very square. So McGill straying down the leg side and short for the left-hander.
He can't afford to be short on this pitch. Just give Chanderpaul enough time. Good sensible shot as well. Didn't try to work it squarer on the offside. Just nudged it fine. And the outfield doing the rest.
Bowling to the two left-handers. Chanderpaul and Jacobs. Chanderpaul on 90. Jacobs on a struggling 26. Been dropped twice in consecutive overs. Half volley 4. You want him driving through the offside, but you can't afford to have him driving through the offside with width. And that is just a free hit for a player in that form. An easy boundary for Chanderpaul.
He's much admired here in Guyana. Big stride forward. And hits it in the gap. Only one result.
Well fielded. Chanderpaul trying to get himself in the record books as well. Just 66 balls for his 94. Staggering performance. Takes him to 95. This takes him to 96. Poor throw from Ponting. Just a little bit tardy, the Australians at the moment. Just couple of drop catches, an overthrow, poor throw from their best fields and Ponting. Some loose deliveries. Really, it's just Gillespie at one end doing it himself, and that's the easy boundary to begin this over. So just 4 runs shy of what will be a memorable century in front of his home crowd. Half shout from Stuart McGill.
Oh, they've seen it before against Emil here last year. Something the West Indian dressing room will be given a great lift with if Chanderpaul, if and when he gets there.
Wonderful rearguard action from Chanderpaul.
There it is. 100 off 67 balls in front of his home crowd. 69 balls. So what a century. His seventh test century. Third fastest in terms of balls faced in the history of the game. And that is a brilliant century as he kisses the pitch. Didn't see him coming on his Pope-mobile. He did that last year when he scored his 100 on this ground as well. So a fabulous century under enormous pressure, and he took the attack of the Australians and has defeated the Australians in this short period of time. 69 balls for 100. It's only Viv Richards and Jack Gregory in front of him in terms of balls faced. So that puts him third in the history of the game. 5 for 184.
Short McGill comes off, 9 overs, 3 maidens, no wicket for 45. Andy Bickle, 5 overs, 1 for 32, got the wicket of Brian Lara today. So Steve Waugh goes back to his quicker bowlers.
Ryan Chanderpaul, very quick century this. This was a shot that brought up the century. Beautifully played again through the offside. Certainly has played some magnificent shots. And the cause, of course, he has gotten there this quickly. Still looking a very fresh batsman at the crease.
Leg before, Bickle has come back and got the wicket of Chanderpaul. And he looks as if he's also heard he's down. So what a dramatic way to end what has been a quite dramatic innings. Chanderpaul floored, leg before as well. And it looks as if he'd been hit in a very delicate spot.
Well, that's interesting. I have to see exactly where he was hit. Because, of course, he has been given out LBW. But more problems for the West Indies. Chanderpaul out, which is something they would not have wanted for him to lose his wicket. But now also injured. Well, this is how he was out. I think he was hit on the inside of the knee. That is the problem. Perhaps not a great deal of protection on the inside of the knee where that ball hit. Crumbled.
New batsman is fast, but Drake, who is having his first test match in the West Indies at the age of 33, circumstances for that well known, was in South Africa for 6 years, ineligible for West Indies selection until last year. Not his first test match, he had two against Bangladesh in December.
And he's there because Shivnarine Chanderpaul was adjudged out LBW. Have a look at this again. You'll see that the ball has pitched clearly outside the line of leg stump. That has pitched perhaps 5-6 inches outside the line of leg stump. It would have hit the stumps, no doubt about that. It has hit him low enough. Has hit him just on the inside of the leg stump line. Would have hit the stumps, but certainly the direction in which the ball was heading, it was heading towards the stiff cordon. Should have told the umpire if it's going to hit the stumps, it must have pitched outside the leg.
That's well taken. That's beautifully held by Gilchrist. They're going to check it out. He's given him. That's beautifully taken. Very, very low down indeed. Got the gloves under it. And Drakes goes without scoring. Superb catch by Gilchrist. And the West Indies, having had that big partnership between Jacobs and Chanderpaul of 131, have now lost 2 wickets in quick succession.
That's a good catch. Just fending at the ball there, Vassbert Drakes. No need to playing a shot like that. This isn't really a one-day game to be looking to run the ball down to the third man region. Doesn't want to go, but in the end he has to. It was a good catch by Adam Gilchrist. Got the glove right under the ball. It's 184 for 7.